When it comes to brain health, some molecules get all the attention. There's melatonin, creatine, and omega-3s. Those are all becoming household names in neuroscience circles. But what if one of the most potent neuroprotective compounds is something you walk past in the produce aisle every single week? Today's episode is about a forgotten flavonoid found in a variety of plant-derived food products, including spinach, kale, broccoli, and apples, to name a few. The compound itself isn't sexy, and it's not trendy, but the data we're going to look at today suggests that this compound may quietly do what many neurotropic ingredients promise but fail to deliver: protect the brain at its most vulnerable interfaces. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Daily Value. I'm William Wallace, and today we're unpacking a molecule that sits at the intersection of diet, neuroinflammation, and mitochondrial resilience. Back in the 1930s, a curious compound isolated from oranges caught the attention of a particular Nobel laureate. At the time, it was believed to be a missing piece of the vitamin puzzle dubbed vitamin P. It didn't quite fit the mold of vitamins as we know them today, but its ability to strengthen capillaries and modulate cellular function couldn't be ignored. Decades passed. The vitamin label was dropped. Interest waned, and the world moved on. But recently, this same molecule, once shelved in the category of nutritional trivia, has come roaring back into focus in a completely different field, that one being neuroscience. This is the story of camphorol and why it might be one of the most neuroprotective compounds you've never heard of. Camphorol is a dietary flavanol naturally found in vegetables like kale, spinach, and broccoli, as well as teas and citrus fruits. If you've ever eaten a gooseberry, well, congratulations, you've ingested camphorol. Before it caught the attention of neuroscientists, camphorol was already quietly building a reputation in the lab. It reduced inflammation, neutralized free radicals, and modulated enzymes linked to chronic disease. In animal studies, it showed promise in cardiovascular health, metabolic balance, and even in cancer models, but these effects were seen mostly on the periphery: systemic inflammation, liver markers, insulin sensitivity, and so on. It's even used to improve male erectile quality nowadays. For years, camphorol was praised for its antioxidant properties, but never quite taken seriously as a player in brain health. That's beginning to change. A growing number of studies are now pointing towards camphorol's ability to cross the blood-brain barrier, although there are important limitations there that I will address shortly. And it's been found to protect neurons in different models of neurodegeneration, like Parkinson's and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, or ALS as it's called. However, unlike direct and common antioxidants like vitamin C or vitamin E, camphorol doesn't work by simply acting as an antioxidant. Its function is even more dynamic than common polyphenols like curcumin and resveratrol. Its secret lies in the microarchitecture of a cell, where mitochondria, calcium, and inflammation all collide at the cellular crossroads of brain health. One study in particular, published just this year, is helping to explain how. Published by Pilato and colleagues in the journal Acto Neuropathologica Communications, looked into how camphorol protects neuronal mitochondria under oxidative stress, specifically through regulation of a protein that's called GRP75. But why does that matter? GRP75 is a protein that physically links the endoplasmic reticulum of a cell to mitochondria at specialized contact sites. The endoplasmic reticulum, among other things, holds and releases calcium, which is essential for neuronal signaling and memory formation. These sites, where the ER, as it's called, interface with mitochondria, are necessary for transferring calcium and other molecules that regulate energy production, cellular recycling, and cellular signaling. In this particular study, neuronal cells that are actually found in the spinal cord were exposed to inflammatory and oxidative stress, causing impaired mitochondrial dynamics and reduced GRP75 activity. However, with camphorol treatment, mitochondrial membrane potential was preserved, calcium uptake was increased, and GRP75 levels normalized. Camphorol not only preserved mitochondrial structure, but reprogrammed cells for better resilience. What essentially happened was that camphorol normalized the mitochondria's ability to make ATP or energy. Even at very low concentrations, camphorol nearly doubled the mitochondria's calcium uptake ability, which in this case was a good thing. Most interestingly, this may be the first compound that has been found to target both the endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria directly and simultaneously in this specific way with this specific mechanism. This study builds on a growing body of work showing how camphorol acts on multiple interlocking systems. It has been shown to inhibit microglial activation. Those are the brain's immune cells, largely responsible for neuroinflammatory damage. In models of Alzheimer's disease, camphorol has been shown to inhibit acetylcholine esterase, reduce amyloid beta aggregation, and modulate BDNF expression. In Parkinson's models, it reduced neuroinflammation and protected dopaminergic neurons, even inhibiting pathways like NLRP3 and inflammasome activation that are increasingly recognized in age-related neurodegeneration. In stroke models, camphorol protects the blood-brain barrier and promotes autophagy to clear damaged mitochondria, which is essential in preventing post-ischemic neuronal death or the death of neurons after somebody experiences a stroke. In depression and anxiety models, camphorol mimics endocannabinoid effects by inhibiting an enzyme that degrades mood-improving lipids involved in endocannabinoid signaling, that being fatty acid amide hydrolase. In animal models, camphorol doses range from 10 to 100 milligrams per kilo of body weight, typically delivered orally. Human equivalents would need adjustments, but a ballpark figure might land in the 100 to 500 milligrams daily range for meaningful effect. However, one challenge is bioavailability. Camphorol is very poorly absorbed. Actually, only 2% of camphorol from food is absorbed. It's also rapidly metabolized. However, there are newer delivery strategies like liposomes or pairing camphorol with phospholipids. This could enhance the uptake due to the ability of camphorol to combine with or dissolve in lipids and fats. Camphorol could slot neatly into a daily nootropic or longevity formula, particularly for those targeting neuroinflammation, mitochondrial resilience, or cognitive decline. So where does this all leave us? Camphorol isn't a magic bullet, but it's shaping up to be remarkably versatile and even lacks any known toxicity. It's a compound that's been overlooked in the neuroprotection conversation. It supports the core themes of brain longevity, those being energy metabolism, inflammation control, and structural integrity. While your kale salad won't deliver a therapeutic dose, the research strongly supports camphorol's place in next-generation neuroformulations. This is one of those molecules we may look back on and say, we should have been paying attention sooner. Thank you for joining me today on Daily Value. If today's episode was enjoyable for you, please subscribe and share it with someone who cares about brain health. As always, stay sharp and stay healthy.